Dad, I'm sorry, but if I gave you one thing, God knows where it might lead.
There's still something missing.
You must be kidding, Dad. My God, this place couldn't look any more ludicrous.
Well, there's a Christmas tableau, naughty and nice.
Yes, here we are. Preferred songs from a Victorian Christmas and Elizabethan tidings of joy. Now we're ready to party.
I used to love this stuff when I was 6. By the time I was 7, I started to have questions. When I was 8, I started spending a lot more time at the Bernsteins.
Daphne.
Hello. Oh, that's awfully dangerous, Daphne. Standing there under that mistletoe.
That's enough eggnog, Niles.
Hey, Fraser, what time's your party tonight?
Shh, please, keep your voice down. You're the only one from the station I've invited.
The only one?
Yes.
It's Maris's way of saying I love you. She always uses money to get what she wants. Ergo, this is proof she wants me back. What do you think?
Oh, oh, oh. I think Santa said it all for us.
Afternoon, all.
Oh, hello, Daphne.
That's awfully dangerous, Daphne, standing under that mistletoe. A piece could fall into your eye.
Let me freshen your drink, Niles.
Oh, Niles.
I'm getting high on reefer.
Oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine!
Turns out he had some bad health news from his doctor. He didn't even last a year.
Well, first of all, I can see you're upset, so come here.
You hit one note, and you slide up the octave as you descend slowly into a crouched position. Observe. You see, it works.
Hey, my Uncle John.
Look at you. Just saying his name gets you upset. Come here.
Well, I'm fine.
No, you need a hug.
Well, all right.
For those of you who have not yet sampled the punch, here is my capsule review. Vile bouquet, unwholesome color, ghastly taste, and a kick that is simply heaven.
And exactly which of your connections in the Seattle demimonde is going to get you this reefer?
Okay, Niles, you're hooked up.
Well,
what are the odds?
The way my son is due in an hour, and on top of it all, I have to go to a mall.
Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, don't look at me. He said it.
Ooh, I'd like to tear into one of those gifts right now.
Well, not until Christmas morning, Mary. You know, in my house, we don't even shake the boxes.
I'm a little preoccupied. I'm having a party tonight for 200 people.
Very interesting. I wonder if the reverse is true. Mm-hmm.
No!
Try it, Dad. No, I'm afraid with 3 of us doing it, it might look stupid.
Fraser, don't pretend to be sorry. All you care about is your precious party that you're hosting tonight.
We celebrate peace and togetherness.
People will go almost anywhere for free food and booze. Am I really so insufferable?
I could call the station and see if people want to come over.
Oh, yes, Roz. Let's call in the second string guests. Let's fill my home with a bunch of angry, snubbed co-workers. You think they'd come?
Fashionably late. Hello, everyone. Come in. Merry Christmas.
Okay, Marty, how'd you get these people down here?
Oh, I just called an old buddy in the fire department, told him that many people in one place had to be a code violation.
Oh, that is smart. Aren't there going to be the same number of people down here?
All right, everyone. We'll start by singing some carols, and then we'll choose up teams for the minister's cat.
I don't think that's going to be a problem.
Mm-hmm.